Hey everybody, hope you're doing well. Hope you've enjoyed the weekend and had a great first week of classes of, virtual learning. So sorry we didn't get the chance to see each other on Thursday. I just wanted to go through and show you a couple examples based on the reading and the lecture videos that you hopefully have had the chance to check out. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen here and just walk you through a couple things. Building some major scales from different tonics, identifying and writing out different key signatures. Here we go. So first, let's start with building some major scales. If you recall, there's a couple steps that we take for this process. And also, one of the most important things to remember is which scale degrees the half steps fall between, which are scale degrees 3 and 4 and 7 and 1. And on the natural notes that are found on the keyboard, those half steps fall between the notes E and F and B and C. So let's just build some major scales here. Let's start with a F major scale. So step one is to put all the notes on the staff from F to F. And from there, we go through and make sure that all the intervals or all the steps between each scale degree match the formula of whole, whole, half, whole, 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 half. So we're starting with F. F to G is a whole step, that's good. G to A is a whole step, that's also good. A to B is a whole step, but we need that to be a half step. So we just have to lower that B to a B flat. Now we have a half step between scale degrees 3 and 4, which are the notes A to B flat in the key of F. B flat to C is a whole step, that's good. C to D is a whole step, D to E is a whole step, and now E to F, which is our scale degree 7 to 1, should be a half step. And naturally, it is a half step in the key of F. So there you go. There's your F major scale. So the key signature for F would be 1 flat, which is a B flat. So if I wanted to, I could come in and add that key sig. And there you go. Key of F. Let's do another one. Let's try one with a couple more accidentals. How about, the key of F sharp major. So again, we start, let's not do F sharp, we just did F. So let's do the key of, let's do C sharp. So again, we just put the notes on the staff from C sharp to C sharp. And now we go through and make sure that all the intervals between each note match the major scale formula. So starting with C sharp to D right away, that should be a whole step and that's a half step. Raise that to a D sharp. D sharp to E should be a whole step, it's a half step. So we gotta raise that E to an E sharp. Now E sharp to F is actually an enharmonic equivalent because E sharp shares the same pitch as F, but it's a different note name. So that being said, that is a unison that should be a half step. So we just have to raise that F to an F sharp. Now F sharp to G is another half step, which should be a whole. So raise that G to a G sharp. G sharp to A should be a whole step, but that's a half step. Raise that. A sharp to B, again, should be a whole step, but it's a half step. So we got to raise that B to a B sharp. And now B sharp to C sharp is indeed our half step. So the key of C has 7 sharps. So if we wanted to see that key signature, there you go. I meant to say the key of C sharp has 7 sharps. So if we wanted to move all those sharps to the beginning of the staff, it looks like that. Let's try a couple in bass clef. All right, so how about we do the key of G? So again, we start by putting all the notes on the staff from G to G. And now we go through and make sure that all the intervals match the major scale formula. G to A, 1 to 2 is a whole step, that's good. A to B, 2 to 3 is a whole step, that's good. B to C, naturally a half step, that's good. C to D, another whole step, which is good because 4 to 5 is a whole step. D to E should be a whole step, which it is, 5 to 6. 6 to 7 should be a whole step, but we've got E to F, which is a half step. So we gotta raise that F to an F sharp. And then F sharp to G is our second half step of the scale, which is scale degree 7 to 1. So again, if we wanted to see that key signature, the key of G is just 1 sharp, an F sharp. Looks like that. Do one more. How about the key of E flat? So again, we'll start by adding all the notes from E flat to E flat on the staff. Now we go through with the formula, 1 to 2. E flat to F is a whole step, which is good. F to G is a whole step, which is good. G to A is a whole step. That should be a half step, so what do? We lower that A to an A flat. Now A flat to B is 3 half steps, and we only want 2 half steps or a whole step, so we have to lower that B to a B flat. B flat to C is a whole step, which is good. C to D is a whole step, which is good. And now scale degree 7 to 1, which is D to E flat, is already a half step. So no more alterations need to be made. Now again, if we want to see what that key signature looks like, there you go. The key of E flat has 3 flats in it, B flat, E flat, and A flat. And while we're here, why don't we just quickly take a look at these key signatures. And remember the step for identifying in the flat key signatures, you can either just look to the second to last flat in the series, which here is an E flat, which correlates with the key of E flat, and that works. Or you can count down 4 notes from the last flat in the series. So this flat happens to be on an A flat. So if we count down 4 from A, A is 1, G is 2, D is 3, and E is 4. That means that we're in the key of E flat. Now, with the sharps, the main thing to do is to look to the last sharp in the series and just go up a half step from that sharp, and that tells you the key. Because if you remember, the last sharp in the series correlates with the 7th scale degree of whatever key you're in. So if the last sharp in this series is an F, F sharp, a half step above F would be G, which puts us in the key of G. Same thing here. It may look kind of like a mess of sharps, but all you got to do is look to that last sharp in the series, which is on a B, and go up a half step from B sharp, which kind of similar to the E or the what was that? The E sharp and the F natural. So B sharp's enharmonic equivalent is C natural. So instead of going up a half step to B natural, we'd have to go up a half step. I'm sorry, up a half step to C natural. We go up a half step from B sharp to C sharp. So that puts us in the key of C sharp here. And now this one with the flats, F is one of those keys where you can't go to the second to last flat because there's only 1 flat in the series. So all we have to do is count down 4 steps from where the last flat in the series is, which is on a B. So B is 1, A is 2, G is 3, and F is 4, which puts us in the key of F. Now, if we switch over to the virtual piano to play some of these scales, let's play an F scale. So we go F, G, A, and then we've got that B flat, C, D, E, back to F. Let's try a C sharp scale. So if we start on C sharp, D sharp, and here's that E sharp, which is also the same note as F, half step to F sharp, G sharp, A sharp, B sharp, which you'll see is also C natural, and C sharp again. How about the key of G? We can play that one. Here's our starting note, G, A, B, half step to C, D, E, whole step to F sharp, back to G. And our final was E flat. So we started on the E flat, whole step to F, whole step to G, half step to A flat, whole step to B flat, whole step to C, whole step to D, and a half step to finish her off, back to E flat. So there you go. Hope that makes some sense and helps a little bit. As always, feel free to shoot me an email with any questions you may have. And if I don't hear from any of you, I'll plan on seeing you all on Tuesday for our first quiz.